Starts right now. Yes. It's 3 o'clock.
Connecting, talking through my soul. It's a voice. What allows our voice wants to in order to stay. When we are assigned this body, we get taught all these things from all these different people. That's our programming. This is what stays within us. Once you get to your root, most people awaken because they hip hop on and they're physically exhausted and their soul put them through a trial. But some people awaken because they can hit rock bottom, they see everyone else hit rock bottom. And so now they want to prevent that from happening. They would like to start off fresh. This could start off with eating, changing your patterns, your everyday routine, meditating, working out, changing your job, the way you think, or even who you keep into your life. As you awaken, your soul is now coming back online. You're getting control of your body. Now you're able to react and respond to ways you think you're feeling best. You're able to process and program things that you know are destined for your life. So this comes through meditation or even centering yourself in nature, a beach, sand, a forest, even your backyard if it's simple. But when you meditate, you're able to connect to these angels. You're able to connect to these gods. You're able to connect to your higher self, whether you see yourself or not, and you'll get messages. Some come through in flames of energy, some come through as vibration. Sometimes people do vividly see themselves, other people that have crossed over, or some of the angels that they have. Some clients have a happy place. They go to this beach, they go to this forest, and they're calm. This is their serenity. This is where they like to be every time they meditate, because it helps them get back into their zone. Okay, I had a bad day. I reacted, something triggered me again. Let me meditate. Let me get back to this form of self. Let me see from my perspective what zen me, what took me out, so you can release it, go through another day, and not carry the same energy. For people that go down and do not wake up, it's as if you're carrying a bad past on your back. And every person that you cross paths with will tell you, don't you think it's easier to let that go? Don't you think it's time to make peace with your past? Don't you think it's time to let go of some things that no longer serve you? I just told someone this today. You want to take off this bag. You want to throw it off. You think it's as simple as letting it go. As a spiritual teacher, I make you acknowledge everything that is in that bag. So you can know what is attached to you, how it programs you, why you allowed it to happen for so long, and how you became blind to it. Because what you were consciously aware and alert of, something must have altered your life, shifted your focus or your perspective, and allowed it to enter your subconscious. Therefore, it doesn't exist. It doesn't happen. You got over it, it's no longer important. Until the retriggering happens, when you awaken. Now you're forced to make peace with this. Now you have to let it go. Now you have to accept it, heal from it, and grow through this process. So now everything that you went through, you can share as an experience, as a testimony. As you awaken, you become more happiness. You gain back your power. You get back your purity. You're finally happy because you're not waiting until something makes me happy or someone makes me happy. I'm happy with the way I look. I'm happy with the way I feel. I'm happy with the way I dress. I'm happy with the person I am. And I'm happy with the way I impact all this world. You're giving yourself happiness. And who doesn't have happiness? You want to share that. You want to enlighten. You want to help them become happier and make them more conscious because you see what it's like to exist on this earth. You want everyone to start living. You get love back, you get your peace, you receive knowledge, you have bliss. At this point, nothing or no one can alter you. No one can spare you from where your peace of mind is, because you've already reprogrammed yourself. You taught yourself what power is. It's not power for dangerous use. It's power to have control over your mind, body, and spirit. So that way you know, again, not everything reserves a response or a reaction. Period. Doesn't matter anything about being a bird, let's pick it out of your head. Purity is about cleansing your soul. Saying that I went through all this old programming, I completely corrupted myself and took away what does not benefit me, and I'm pure. I'm happy, I am myself. Happiness. There you go. You put yourself back into a state of zen. You're your young self, you're soulful, you're happy, you're enlightened, because you're back to what you were as a kid. There was no fear, there was no anxiety, there was no doubt, there was no anything. You're calm. You're okay. You're fine. That same love you have from wanting to connect with friends and family, the excitement you see with connecting people, it all starts to come back. At this point, now people are coming to you. People who are awakened and some who are not. The ones that aren't awakened, you help awaken them. You can't save them. You can't heal them, which will explain how this process and journey is going to be for them so they can understand their signs of awakening as well. This knowledge grows. Okay? Because at this point, you're intrigued. You want to learn more. You want to make a difference on this earth. You want to help people. Maybe some of you will be life coaches. Maybe some of you are going to be life therapists. Maybe some of you are thinking of counseling yourself, or you're thinking of more something holistic or alternative. This is the way to go about it. To put yourself in a self-healing. Yes, we all need psychics, we need readers, we need mediums, we need tarot cards. We can be that ourselves. We can do what we need. We can be who we want. Because the list that we have is infinite. We are all one. We were sent here to be brothers and sisters, but we lost focus. Because our tribe came in, we had stubborn energy, and we all wanted to be against each other. Now we're all fighting for fame. We're fighting for love. We're fighting for attention. That we don't care to help each other. We don't care to make a difference. It's all about us, 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 us. It's time for the ego to go down, love to come back up. So when we make a difference, we know that it's with kindness of our own heart. We're not forcing ourselves to. We're not doing something because someone asked us to. We're doing it because we want. We're doing it because we felt we had to. So when you cross paths, everyone is your brother and sister. Help them. Listen to them. Listen to a point of understanding, not just letting it go through one ear and out the other. Because you never know. It might take a lot of courage for someone to find themselves on how they felt. Maybe someone was holding the same for the longest time and there it goes. And you're not listening. You're not understanding. You're hearing from your perspective. You would want someone to listen to you. You would want someone to care for you. We all need to be the person we didn't have when we were young. I was broke. I was poor. I was homeless. My parents were separated. I've been in foster care. I lost hope. Just these past few years, I got back on my feet. Because I did. I was done settling for this. I was done keeping people in life that were not meant to be there in the first place. I was done forcing myself into a cycle pattern. I was putting myself there, thinking this marriage needs to last. These family members need to be proved, and I can't fear any rejection. I went through it all. Only through these last few years, I gained my strength back. Because I was done waiting for someone to make me happy. I was done waiting for someone to say, good job, Carol, you did it. Here's this blessing. It doesn't work like that. Because one, everyone else has something going on in their own life. They sure don't care about what's going on in mine. So I stopped. Depending, expecting, and waiting. I gave myself my freedom. I'm not waiting for someone to say yes, go ahead, or control me. I gained my power, so I got my purity back. I forgave myself and everyone else. Because I finally understood why they were going through what they were going through. Going through these life experiences, I was able to reflect and understand, oh, this is why you taught me what you taught me. This is why you reacted how you reacted. This is why you said what you said. But I forgive you. And I apologize. And I hope you forgive me as well. You make peace with the past so you can have peace in the present and actually receive abundance in the future. But if you're scared, if you're worried, in which we all are, because the unknown is unknown. We create our own future. We create our own happiness. We create our own abundance, and it's up to us to do so. All the universe can do, all the world can do, is give us these tools, give us these resources. And it's okay to ask for help. It's okay to say, I don't know how to do this, or ask a question. Because as soon as you get clarity, you're right back on that road to happiness, to strength. This is a time. My assistant knows. I encourage you. I'm not the greatest person. I'm far from it. But I'm Leo. So why is Leo not courageous? Because something happened to me in life. I didn't have to apply it anymore. So it's simmered down. Now I'm entering a part of my life. It has to come back. But I feel it as not negative, but empowered. How am I going to use this power? How am I going to use this courage? In which ways do I apply it? How do I know I'm not going too far for it? And how do I know I'm not applying myself enough? I'm a vessel, I'm a medium, because I chose to agree to be here on earth, go through these life experiences, to help each and every one of you. To help you understand why we go through what we go. To help you understand that there is a solution, there is peace, there is happiness, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, but you have to believe. You have to have faith. Anytime you're clouded by fear, you'll only see things in a negative pattern. And that's something you learn to release. Forgive peace with exes, family members, mother-in-laws, yourself, your brothers or sisters. because they didn't know, just like you do. You awaken, they awaken, you all share your experiences together, family comes together, friends understand. There's no problems, there's no more complications. And yes, we're all going to make a difference. Yes, we're going to make an impact, but it starts within ourselves. When you're done being unhappy and negative, the world will stop being unhappy. When you start to make peace and abundance, everyone else picks up on that energy. Then you're not letting people enter and take from you. We are givers. We are lovers. Every time we cross paths with someone who's dramatic or too much or always needy, takey. What does that do to us? Okay, fine, you take it. Okay, here you go. Okay, just get away from me now. But they just took a piece of us. A piece of our mind, our emotional state, maybe our physical state. Maybe we had a big plan today. We can't do it. Because you just let them make one money. You just let them have their car. You just gave them, you took a day off work. You couldn't need that. You stopped what you're doing to other people because you have a kind heart. Now it's time to make the boundaries in your life that you need. Create a line. In this line, I'm not going to let people take advantage of you. I'm not going to let people lie to you. I'm not going to let people abuse you. Be an answer. Put yourself in the wrong. It's okay to isolate yourself. It's okay to have the self-reflection. It's okay to understand everything. But don't be scared of where you're going to be once you exit. Because it's a transformation. Going from the caterpillar we are, I just put you in a cocoon. Now I'm going to show you how you can't wait to become better person. Who are you going to become? What are you going to have? How are you going to give it to yourself? When do you feel you are ready? Why is this happening to you? And what got you here? With all those who, what, when, where, whys, and hows, you have a game plan. You have a goal. The time frame you give yourself, those are accomplishments. Make them short, make them long. But don't lose direction along the way. Don't lose faith. It's okay to stop for directions. But only if they know where you're going. Only if they too have been down the same path. Then they can help you see. They'll assist you with getting there. And you can ask your angels, you can ask your guides, you can ask your higher self, even the ones that have crossed over. Help me. Show me signs. Take things away. Clear my path. There could be a lot of debris. Maybe a car stopped in your path, you can't go around it. It's going to take a miracle to take that away. But you know, you can't do it on your own. That's the time you ask for your guidance. That's the time that you release it. And be yourself. And you'll be happy. You let everything come through that you were holding yourself back from in the beginning. Then once you get to this point, you laugh at yourself. What was I scared of in the first place? Why did I wait? What was I thinking? Why did I not believe I could do this before? And you start to have more faith in yourself. Now your self-love is there. Now your contentment, your strength, your courage, your bravery, your energy, it's all aligned. You're going back to your supreme soul. You're telling the universe of angels, thank you. I don't see how I was going to do this before. Oh, I guess I do. Because of that. But there's no because of you. Because of him. Because of her. Because you make peace with all of them. It's not anyone's fault. I have. They hurt me. They disappoint me. They betrayed me. They sure did. But I forgive them. Because they needed something I had to make themselves more beneficial. To make themselves more empowered. And obviously, I have. So, they need it more than I did. I could replace it. Money's replaceable. Car's replaceable. House replaceable. Liquids are replaceable. Food is replaceable. But we know we're going to have to work it into it. So it strains us. It makes us upset with them. We blame them for putting us in this horrible position. Once again, because they don't know how long it took to get out there. So that's why when you awaken, that doesn't happen. They can't affect you. You make peace with it, and you know what? I know you're going to ask for money. Here it is, a guarantee in advance. I don't want anything. Here you go. I already finished your car for you. Don't worry. I don't need any money. I got some coming in as long as you're back on the road. Here, I've washed your kids. I fed them. I ate them. I did everything. Don't give me a dollar. It's fine. Because you're not expecting anything in return. Nothing has to be acknowledged. The world does not owe you any favors. You owe yourself peace. You owe yourself charity. You owe yourself a balance and harmony. Because the more you blame, the more people will sin. You didn't have to. I didn't ask you to. You didn't need to. But you shouldn't make peace with it. It's not my problem. It's still affecting you. I'm moving on with it. But that's where resentment comes from. I'm still mad. I'm still bitter. I'm still angry. I'm still unhappy. Why are they living their life? Why are they okay? Why are they moving on? Why are they living their life the way they get to, and I'm stuck like this? Because you chose to. Because they chose to. They chose to make peace with it. It doesn't bother them. They were users. They were takers. They had nothing to train you. They had nothing to give you. But it sucks because you let these good people, or you fuck with good people, come in and do it. And now you have to work all over. You forgive them and pray for their awakening. Forgive them. Make peace. Allow yourself to be happy again. Give yourself sleep. Give yourself clarity. Make sure that you can wake up every day with a smile on your face. Have affirmations. I'm going to have a good day. I'm going to help someone today. I'm going to donate money today. I'm going to be strong. I'm going to be a confident counselor. I'll be a confident firefighter. I'm going to be a confident nurse. And you run with that. So anytime you see someone else who is unhappy, you know to enlighten them. Encourage them. Bring them consciously online. Because maybe they're stuck in their subconscious too. Maybe they don't understand what's going on in life, and they need answers. Maybe these answers you got are solutions to you. I don't know. But give that same clarity to them. Because we have to be who we want it to be when we grow up. I wish people did this in school. Teach kids, enlighten them, get them to understand why society is the way it is. But we don't do that for some reason. They let us be programmed so they can get paid and have their life, and they can take vacations and be free while we're all working off trying to be known. Instead of fitting in and being our unique self, we keep trying to be programmed. Wake up. Don't fit in. We're not robots. We have a mind. We have a heart. We have a vessel. You are our own person. Start living your life the way you want to live. Start giving your freedom back. Don't be angry. And if you have to make peace with them in person, do it in person. You'll make peace. You'll feel better. You'll walk away the bigger person. Make peace over the phone if you have to. It's okay. Maybe they're not local. If they've crossed over, make peace still. Forgive them. Ask for forgiveness. You'll give it spiritually. You'll receive it spiritually. And the chores will open for you. And everything falls into place as it's meant to. The only person that's blocking your blessings is yourself. The only person that's blocking your ambition is yourself. The only person that's stopping you from receiving the love that you so give freely to other people is yourself. Because you're not receiving it from the people who are truly trying to love you. You're trying to get the attention from those that are running.
I'm going to hand
it out to them. The more they run, the more you chase. The more they run, the more you chase. Because I have answers. I'm a good person. I'm amazing. I have wonderful energy. So why are you going to life? Why are you going to stay? I don't get it. This makes no sense. You go and you go and you go and you go. Until eventually you get tired of that. You give up. But then you feel stuck at a different end of the road. Do I keep running because I'm this close to my answers? Or do I just give up because this is not going to be anything? And that's what different happens. Because now you're starting to apply what you've experienced and that response. Now your higher self should know at this point, do I repeat the cycle or do I evolve? You repeat when it's not meant, when it's not destined, it's not part of your purpose or your mission. So, you evolve. You repeat only when you do not learn your lesson. Do these repetitive cycles keep coming back into your life? Do these thought patterns keep coming back? Do the emotional states keep coming back? Either because you're ignorant, you're arrogant, or you just straight up don't want to. Because once you let go, once you make peace, again, you don't know what happens. Who do I become? What does this do now? What doors does this open? Where does this lead? We're all Alice in Wonderland, and our Wonderland is our Wonderland. Not everyone's going to understand. Not everyone's going to support us. And that's why it's not good to get attached. Do not allow yourself to mentally and emotionally become too attached. We're all temporary. Everything in life is temporary. It's an experience, it's a test, it's a lesson, and we have to learn. School doesn't teach us anything. We apply it in a different way. That's part of programming. We definitely lose. But what are you going to reprogram yourself of? What is bliss to you? What is knowledge to you? What is peace? How do you feel when you hear the word peace? What is love? Because you're so giving to everyone else. But what are you going to receive? How are you going to receive it? When do you know that you have it? Happiness. People think it's a mood. It's not a mood. It's a lifestyle. It's a way of life. When you are happy, nothing can bring you down. When it's a mood, you're depending on something or someone to change you. So uplift you. Either because you don't want to or you're not there. Purity. You want someone to see the best of you. To acknowledge all the hard work that you did. To see the person that you became. To understand the trials and tribulations you faced. That's dependency. That's selfish. understand where I've been. It's no longer who I am. I'm not letting it define me. And I'm whole. I'm happy. And I'm here in my own sense of voice. Power. Do not use this in a negative way. Your power is power of your mind, power of your emotions, power of your physical resistance, and your spiritual soul enlightenment. If you are controlling, if you are demanding, if you are bossy, if you are using your power in a negative way that does not make people feel better, you're doing something wrong. Communicate with them. I'm sorry I made you feel this way. In which way should I change? What did I do? How did I make you feel? I apologize. I'm not doing it again. Then you know what to critique. Then you know what to avoid. Then you know what you're doing wrong, and you can align yourself back into your shit. And everything works out the way you want because you're choosing to keep your path open. There's no debris, there's no blockage, there's no obstacles. Free road, beautiful environment, and you're enjoying the journey. You're enjoying it a lot. It's time to start living. There's no more existing, because if you exist, you're spinning in. Does anyone have any questions? I feel like I talked everyone's head.